Hello, welcome to this lecture video. In this video, I am going to explain material science, quantum free electron theory, which comes under module 5 of engineering physics prescribed by VTU. Here, I am going to explain the following points. That is, quantum free electron theory, merits of quantum free electron theory, and density of states. So, these were all the three points that I am going to explain here. Next, so first I am going to take up quantum free electron theory and the assumptions. So quantum free electron theory was developed by Sommerfeld in the year 1928. So after the development of quantum free electron theory, the classical free electron theory failures were all successfully explained. There are four assumptions given by this quantum free electron theory. The first assumption is distribution of energy in an electron gas obeys Fermi-Dirac quantum statistics, but it does not obey the classical Maxwell-Boltzmann statistical law. This is what the first assumption given by the theory. That means distribution of energy levels in an electron gas obeys the Fermi-Dirac quantum statistics, but it does not obey the classical Maxwell-Boltzmann statistical law. The second assumption is the energy of free electrons in a metal is quantized as according to quantum mechanics. That means the energy of free electrons are quantized as according to the quantum mechanics. And the third assumption is the energy levels in a metal are filled up with electrons in accordance with Pauli's exclusion principle. So the energy levels were all filled up with electrons as according to Pauli's exclusion principle. Pauli's exclusion principle states that no two electrons occupy a particular energy level with all the four quantum numbers the same. That's what the Pauli's exclusion principle. And the following assumptions were all retained. It is already told in classical free electron theory. The fourth assumption is the electrons travels in a constant potential inside the metal but stay confined within its boundaries. Both the attraction between the electrons and the lattice ions and the repulsion between the electrons are totally ignored. So these were all the four assumptions given by quantum free electron theory. Now I am going to talk about merits or success of quantum free electron theory. The specificity is the first point that I am going to discuss here. The small value of specific heat for the conduction electrons can be explained with the help of quantum free electron theory. As per classical free electron theory, the specific heat value Cv is equal to 3 by 2 R, that is what the data given, but it is not in agreement with the experimentally observed data. As per classical free electron theory, all the conduction electrons are capable of absorbing the heat energy. But as per quantum free electron theory, it is only those electrons that are closer to the Fermi level or Fermi energy level are capable of absorbing the supplied heat energy. That is what the main observation made in this theory. According to quantum free electron theory, the specific heat Cv is equal to 2k by EF into RT. So this is what the equation suggested by quantum free electron theory. Since the value of Fermi energy for all the metals ranges from 1 to 10 electron volts, the value of 2k by EF, if we consider, it is approximately equal to 10 to the power of minus 4. That's why Cv is equal to 10 to the power of minus 4 RT. So this equation is in experimentally agree. That's why it is considered as a success of quantum free electron theory with respect to specific heat. Next, I am going to explain what is the temperature dependence of electrical conductivity. According to classical free electron theory, the value of sigma is proportional to 1 by root T. But experimentally observed data shows that the value of sigma is proportional to 1 by T. According to quantum free electron theory, sigma is equal to Ne square lambda by m into Vf, where Vf is Fermi velocity, lambda is mean free path, m or m star that is considered as rest mass of the electron, and n is nothing but number of electrons per unit volume. So here sigma is proportional to n as well as lambda by Vf. Here E and M are going to be constant. So as per classical Fredholm theory, they predicted that sigma is proportional to N. If you consider the temperature of the substance, because of the temperature, the lattice points are going to vibrate about their respective mean position. So if we consider small r is the amplitude of vibration, then the area which blocks by the lattice point for the flow of electrons is found to be pi r square. So as the temperature increases, the value of pi r square also increases. So because of this, as the temperature increases, lambda going to be decreases. That's why lambda is inversely proportional to pi r square. It is observed that the value of r square is directly proportional to temperature T. Therefore, lambda is inversely proportional to T. Since as per the above equation, sigma is proportional to lambda, that's why sigma is proportional to 1 by T. So this is experimentally in agreement with the values whatever we got. Next, I am going to consider the dependence of electrical conductivity sigma on N. How it is depending upon N? As per classical Fredholm theory, sigma is proportional to N, but experimentally observed data is not in agreement with this value. So here, according to quantum free electron theory, the sigma is equal to N square lambda by M into Vf. So if you consider the case of copper and aluminium, I am going to give you the data. That is, the value of N for aluminium is 2.13 times higher than that of copper. But the value of lambda by Vf of copper is found to be 3.73 times greater than that of aluminium. Since the conductivity of copper is greater than that of aluminium, the value of lambda by Vf is in agree with sigma. That means sigma is proportional to lambda by Vf. So this is what the explanation given by quantum free electron theory. Next. So in this slide, I am going to explain density of states. So first, I will give you the definition. Density of states is nothing but the number of available electronic states per unit energy range at a given energy E in the valence band of a material of unit volume. So this is what the actual definition of density of states. So density of states is nothing but number of available electronic states in a unit energy range. So let us consider the energy band spread between energy levels E1 and E2, the number of energy states present in unit volume having energies E and E plus dE is given by G of E dE is equal to 8 root 2 pi m to the power of 3 by 2 by h cube into e to the power of half into dE. So this is what the expression. So G of E dE is nothing but density of states. It gives the number of available electronic states between energy levels E and E plus dE. Here h is Planck's constant, m is mass of the electron. See, if you closely observe the equation, g of E is directly proportional to e to the power of half. When we plot a graph of g of E versus E, the curve obtained is as shown in the graph shown. So it is found to be parabola. So this is what about density of states. Thank you.